Yep, so wind in our back, just dive away from us, just hold it down like that.
What's your availability like this week?
I'll probably do something tomorrow, and then I'm on spring break. We're going to New Braunfels Wednesday through Saturday.
Oh, nice. I was there in August.
Oh, yeah? Yeah, it's gonna be a good time. Looking forward to it. So I see maybe one crew chief over there by that NASA plane.
Yeah.
Yet when a Predator lands, it takes 28 of our maintainers. That's pretty funny, huh?
Nothing
by the helos.
Yeah.
But here comes Ellington, and they got all their swinging dicks over there.
That's how that maintenance group ran, man. That's why I left.
That's terrible.
I just left the mixture rich. I didn't use
I do that too. Just good habit. Especially for training.
Alright, switch to Tower. I want to sit Alta. Flaps are up, verified. And we get the trim.
Roll it forward a little bit. Yeah, that's
about mid range.
Yeah.
Back a little bit. Yeah, sir, where's the... Every plane's different. Landing lights are not, but strobe on.
Uh-huh.
Trim is set, fuel pump is on.
I'll get the canopy just before we go.
Okay.
Alright. And just tell about east departure.
Ellington Tower, November 26794, holding short 1798. Bravo, ready for an east departure, please.
November 26794, Ellington Tower, runway 17 right at Bravo, wind 1706, clear for takeoff.
Clear for takeoff, 17 right, November 26794. Okay. I'm going to give a lot of rudder. Let me adjust my seat here.
Okay, I'll taxi if you want.
Yeah.
Is that better?
Yeah.
Okay, you're a plane, I got right rudder.
I got it.
Alright, rotate 70, climb at 90. Got your air vent on over there under the key, pull that thing out. Yeah. Down a little bit to right about there.
Okay. That's, I was just holding 80.
About 90, remember, miles per hour?
Okay, yeah.
Yep.
Where's our east turn out? want to go out to the area or just straight to LaPorte?
Yeah, let's go out to the air for just a little bit. Keep your, oops, sorry, keep it on the power, yeah. Just below red line, there you go.
I downloaded the trainer for this, so I was playing around with that.
Good.
This is zooming in there.
Zoom is right there with the range in and out. Yep.
Yeah, I just played around with it for a little bit, but I know you can go through here and look at the different freaks and stuff like that.
Yep.
Huh.
Number 9060 Tango Echo, Arlington Tower, report a 4 mile final 17 right.
Report 4 mile final 17 right, 0 Tango Echo.
I don't have the practice area frequency memorized yet. Fine.
Yep, you can switch there now. Going up to 3,000 feet. Let's see how far out we are here. Start a climb. All right, out of 1,000, fuel pump off, landing light off. You make a call. I don't know, we're coming out.
One of these Channel Islands, right?
Yeah.
Where's Alpha and Bravo?
This whole area is Alpha.
Okay.
Bravo's down that way.
By Gallus?
And Charlie's out to the west.
Okay.
So Alpha, Bravo, Charlie.
Okay. Correct, so Alpha, November 26794, passing 1600 for 3000 maneuvers. Huh. This is a little high.
There you go. Big picture, as you climb, make sure we're below 2,000 by the time we cross this, which we're past it, so you're good. You know, some planes you gotta slow the climb down a little bit, but this one not so much. turn to the south on those Channel Islands there. I'll go back to the west over there.
CCC traffic, CSAT 901, 3500 over the eastern edge of Lake Trading House. Keep turning, CCC.
Well, level at 3000 and then we'll just go to cruise flight. I see you lean it out. Leave the power here. Remember, as soon as you see a drop, then you'll go back in a little bit. There you go. Now go back in. Get peak RPM. That's how you lean it, right? That's about it. All right, you go back full, Rich. Just want to make sure you know how to clean it out. And when I do it real fast, because if you do it slow, you'll be a gradual drop. So we're starting at 2480 or so. There's the drop. I'll go back in. Right there.
No EGT gauge on this? You can't tell how.
Nope. Nope, you're just going off of Rich a peak or Lena peak.
Okay.
RPM. Yep, that's it. All right, let's do just do 30 degree bank turns. Let's do a pre-maneuver checklist. We cleared the area. Clear the area. We've already done that. Let's configure the airplane. Make sure it's Rich. Fuel pump on. Landing light on. Just hit it anyway, even though it's not working. Just hit it for. Yep. And make sure Rich good. All right. So plane's configured. Let's just do 30 degree bank turns, both directions. Start and stop at that lake up there. 30 degrees shouldn't take much back pressure. And release a little back pressure there, stay at 3,000 feet. So incorporate your altimeter, lower the nose a little bit. Give that bank coming in, there's 30 right there. You really shouldn't have to pull at 30 degrees of bank. Check ride standards, let's keep it within 100 feet. So you got a VO 1 to 9, that's your limit. There at the point of the lake. Let's go 30 degrees of bank to the right. Again, shouldn't really take any back pressure.
Hello.
Hello. Alright, good. Now we're going to do the same thing.
What's happening?
We'll do 45 degrees of bank. As you roll into it past 30, just add a little bit of power.
Matt, I graduated there in 07. It's been a while.
And same thing, keep within plus or minus 100 feet as best you can.
We're the mighty EMB 145XR.
There you go, power set, that's good. Bring the power back just a little bit, right there.
6 minutes.
Alright, that's 45s right there.
Alright, I'll be waving.
Once you get the pitch set, try to get one of the bug spots on the windscreen and hold it there. That's about 40 degrees. Come on a little bit more bank. Right between those two big lines. That's 45 right there. So you gotta work to hold it there. It's gonna wanna roll its own way. Very good. That's perfect. This is 45 degrees. Excellent. Coming up on the lake, we're gonna roll out. So push the nose back down, hold that altitude. Good.
I just upgraded to June. Pretty
low. It's stable.
Totem pole.
And to the right.
I'll try though.
Boom, right there. There it is. And just hold that nose all the way around.
CSAT 901, 5300, headed back inbound to the school, about 2 to the east of the lake trading house, DFC.
A little more bank, bring about 5 more. There you go. Watch your altitude, just lower the nose a little bit. A little more bank. The only thing you're really watching are these two gauges here. A little more bank. Here comes the lake. Roll out. Push down. Good. Take the power back out. That's check ride standards right there.
Yet.
You push it up to about 2300, 2400. Good. That's check ride standards on speed turns, right? Again, all you need to watch is this and your bank angle.
Yeah.
All right. Everything else should be outside. All right. Continue to track the lake. Get me into slow flight. Number 3 steps, power out, full flaps, and then power back into 2000. So 1500 RPMs, full flaps. That's close enough, go ahead and just start rolling the flaps. Stay at this altitude and this heading, okay? That's what we're looking to do here. And we're gonna fly right at 62 miles per hour there. All right, flaps are down. Pitch up to hold altitude. There it is. Now add your power. See, we got a descent going, so add 2,000 RPMs. Boom, all the way to 2,000. You're descending, see that? Bump it up, bump it up. A little more power, a little more power. And remember to climb, you're gonna have to add power.
Yep.
All right, so let's add a little more to get back to 3,000. You wanna be nat's ass on altitude. Don't accept 50 feet off. So add more power. If you need to jam it up in there, go ahead. Whatever you need to climb and pitch for that airspeed, let's hold about 62. Be controlled by pitch. All right, let's do a left turn to go behind us, a 180, so 10 degrees of bank, no more than that. Let's point to one of the water towers over there, just pick something and keep tracking of that.
Alright, 3 minutes. Or 3 minutes, or no, make that 2 minutes from you. 20 miles to the north.
Alright, so we got altitude looks good. We can come back down, take out a little bit of power, just a little bit. There you go. And we're a little fast, right? Let's correct the speed. We'll pull the nose up a little bit. We want to get right above that stall warning horn. Let's take this into a landing stall, a power off landing stall.
Okay, so just pull the power back, right?
Yeah, pull the power back to idle, just hold the nose here. Once you get a good stall, then go and recover. Yeah, okay, recover. Keep that nose down, just right about there. Hold it, I'll push it down for you. Bring up about 3 more seconds on the flaps. Good, now start cranking back to the way we started over there just a little bit. Good, and get to above 80 before you bring in the rest of the flaps.
Over I-20.
Good. All right, you bring them up, bring the flaps up. Let's continue this to a takeoff stall, so just keep pulling up. All you can do here is you're just going to lower the nose, okay? Just keep your rudder centered, just add a little right rudder, add some right rudder. Get that ball centered and hold that ball centered. That's the biggest thing so you don't spin. That's going to take a little more back pressure, quite a bit of back pressure to get it to stall.
Alright, it says we're right on top of you.
Then hold that nose up, pull it back some more. Keep just wanting to go left, so lower the nose now. Over.
Alright.
Okay, we'll level off here, that's cool. Okay. Alright, just say cruise power. And let's do a left 180. Once you roll out there, you'll see RWJ somewhere over there, off your wing.
Yeah, I see
it. You see it now?
Yeah.
Okay, we're going to use that for a simulated engine failure right now. Here comes an engine failure.
Okay.
Alright, so talk me through what you're doing.
Airspeed.
Alright, so.
And then best field. And then checklist.
Alright, so let's go back to airspeed. So let's trim for the, which will be 80 miles an hour. Alright, so let's trim for that. Look outside, it's going to look like this.
Yeah.
I trim for that. I just got this for the air conditioner right here.
Oh, that's cool.
Oh yeah, I forgot it was noon.
Awesome.
Alright, so look outside. That's right about, there's going to be 80. So if you just hold this all day long, that'll keep you there, okay? Alright, B for best field.
Right there.
Alright, so let's head on over
later,
there.
Yeah, see you later. I'll post that picture of you on the Facebook
page. Let's get rid of this guy because he's a pain in the ass. 22.7. Alright, and what else? What's after B, best field?
And then checklist, so I'll do
touch with your finger, touch everything.
This, mixture. Fuel pump, this guy, and the carb heat.
Okay. Fuel air spark troubleshoot, right?
Yep. And then we'll set 7700 and 1205.
All right, 121.5.
For tower.
Well, 121.5 is emergency.
Yeah, okay, that's right.
All right, so there's RWJ right there. Off.
Yep, I see it.
So I want you to set up to land there on 26 going that way. So kind of make a, we're going to land this direction.
Land this direction?
Going that way, yeah.
Okay.
So you're good here, just kind of go out here, then you can re-enter the downwind up the other way.
Just go overhead and then,
You can, but, yeah. Stay over here, just because the pattern, just for training, we need to stay on this side over here.
Yeah, that's fine. You want me to extend out?
Well, I would do a left 270. We want to enter the downwind right below us at 1,000 feet going that direction.
So I'll just extend out. I'll
stay on this side over here for,
Yeah.
RWJ traffic, 26794, bearing left downwind for 26, currently at a 2000 for 1000 overhead the field, RWJ. Alright, so at this point, you're really focusing on energy management here.
Oh,
well, yeah, we can kill altitude later. For now, keep it coming around now.
Yeah.
That's good, right? really good position here.
Kind of gusty.
This will be a plain low approach, okay, just for training. Just for engine failure.
Yeah, no problem. Turn base now.
Okay, you make the calls.
RWGA traffic, November 26794 is left base for 26. How convenient is that? They have a... like a tower sticking off.
Oh, that's perfect, isn't it? Alright, so we're probably just a little bit high, but we can take care of that yet with flaps if you need to. Once landing's assured.
RWGA traffic, November 26794 is turning final for 26. Low approach.
Low approach only, yep. Roll another notch of flaps, watch your speed, keep it at 80 so don't stall.
Yeah.
I'll start dumping that nose down and bringing some flaps in. There you go. Look at that. Now you can probably go full flaps if you think you got it made. I think we got the concrete made.
Like we're really high.
Perfect, right? Wow, that's perfect for an engine failure. All right, I'm gonna close the canopy, watch your ears. I think we can make that, huh?
Survivable.
All right, let's go around, let's practice a go around. Full power, pitch up. Not too much, lower the nose, that's good. Remember, speed is everything. We'll climb as well we can, but let's get some speed first. Bring up the first few seconds of flaps. Good, 80's your number, remember that. Always at or above 80. Alright, cool. Alright, let's go up to 1500 feet and head to LaPorte.
I was wondering why I was finding me at it trimmed up so much.
Trim, yeah, run that trim, yeah.
1500 feet?
1500 to LaPorte, yep.
There you have it, sir.
Yep. Hit direct to, or watch this, actually, hold on, clear it. Yeah, so you got nearest.
Horn mount to control, horn mount to control, BP 31. Mississippi Canyon 127, Horn Mountain, this is BP 31. Yes, sir. We're about 20 minutes out. We're going to be bringing in two techs and shutting down, waiting on them. Haven't had lunch yet. I was just wondering if you all could leave the lunch line open. We'll be there about 12:30.
There's 1500, yep. Alright, above 1000, fuel pump, any light? So if you go GPS here, you get GPS guidance to LaPorte. Desired track 240, I'll put in 240 here. This is just GWIS, so the desired track's 240, we're currently tracking 234, so if you come 5 right, I'll take exactly there, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's how you use that. That's why I like that feature. I got 9.5 miles to go. That's when I make my calls, I just look at that and go, hey, we're 9 miles to the, you know, look at the bottom of your deal here, to the northeast. Yeah, so this thing here, remember, this is chapters in a book. These are pages within the chapter. So I'm in the nav chapter. Yeah, all kinds of information on your nav, and there's all your information right here. If I want to actually put that in here, I could just highlight it and hit enter, and it puts it in the standby.
Awesome.
Pretty lazy, but whatever.
Fox 26, go ahead.
I haven't heard anybody in LaPorte, so we'll look out. We'll assume 1-2's in use for now.
Point traffic, November 26794, 5 miles to the east, entering downwind traffic for 1-2.
Is your logbook in here?
It is.
All right, I'll just check something real quick.
Bumpy.
Of course.
Somebody.
Yeah, I did too. That sounded like LaPorte, didn't it?
Yeah.
Traffic call LaPorte, say again. Now watch out for them dumb sounding rednecks. Wharton is to the west.
Wharton, I said LaPorte. Port traffic, November 26794, 2 miles to the east, entering downwind for 1-2.
Alright, so I don't think there's anyone else out, so you can go down to 15, or down to 1,000.
LaPorte traffic pipeline 364, Charlie Papa is about 5 miles to the northwest, going to transition on the east side to southbound LaPorte.
He's coming over here. LaPorte traffic 26794 is entering the downwind 1-2 LaPorte, 1,000 feet. I'll watch out for that pipeline guy. Alright, there's 1,000. Level off here.
Port traffic, November 26794 is downwind 1-2. Clock up there, it's in front of us.
Oh yeah.
Oh,
look at that. That's cool. that's cool. Better watch out for that wake turbulence.
Yeah. Oh, we're beaming a little low. I'm not power out.
On final, not right now.
Yeah,
so pitch for about 90 here. Let's figure 90, 85, and 80.
Yeah. Port traffic, November 26794, left base, 1-2. Point traffic, November 26794 is final 1-2. A little too much.
Green.
Shell 16, go ahead, sir.
Apparently, Shell 20 minutes out, down, picking up one and fuel.
Copy that, 20 minutes out, picking up one and fuel. Call me at 5.
Left rudder, there you go, straight it out. Flaps. Remember, start with flaps, car beat, then end with power.
There's that guy right there.
Okay.
Lots of birds out.
Yep.
Port traffic, November 26794 is crosswind to 1-2. Feels like a little piggy today.
Yeah.
Port traffic, November 26794 is down 112.
And switch tanks also.
No, we never turned the fuel pump on.
Yeah, just go ahead and hit the lane light just for habit.
Port traffic, November 26794, left base, 1-2.
So recheck your power, go back to 1500. There you go. This time, don't let it get below 80, okay?
Yep.
So just lower the nose, add more power if you need to. 1500 is just a place to start, so whatever you need. I'd rather you be 5 knots fast than 5 knots slow. You tend to fly on the slow side.
Okay.
We can bleed that speed off on short final.
Port traffic, November 26794 is final 12.
Really, the only thing I'm looking at in the pattern is that airspeed indicator. That's all I really care about. There you go. Now we're up at 90, so now pull the power back. Now start bleeding. Try to keep it at 80 as best you can. Yep, using pitch end power. Nice. A little bit of crosswind, but not too bad.
It floated there for a little bit.
That's okay. I like that. You just kept working it down. That's what I like.
Port traffic November 26794 is crosswind 12.
Look right here, look how steep your deck is. That's where you tend to get really slow, so always keep that nose just on the horizon. And that's where the stalls happen.
Port traffic, November 26794 is left base 12. Let's take that one, call. Port traffic, November 26794 is final 12. Expecting that bush.
squeaking them on now.
Yeah, I took one or two of them, but...
they're real good.
We'll see.
So my only critiques are in the climb, watch your speed. When you're in the turns, you tend to look up the wing, because it's cool to look up the wing, but your speed gets slow. So in the base turn and the crosswind turn, keep your eyes focused out front and on the airspeed indicator. That'll prevent you from popping up and doing that.
Port traffic, November 26794, crosswind 12. Port traffic, November 26794, downwind 12. Too much, man. Port traffic, November 26794, left base 12. Port traffic, November 26794, final 12.
Top that power to idle. There you go. Just bleed it off in the flare, okay?
Yep.
Let's make this a full stop.
Yeah.
Come on down, come on down. Okay, go around, go around, go around, go around. Full power, full power. Carve it in. Hold off on the flaps. Oh, you already brought them up, okay.
Yeah.
Well, let's go sink.
Nice,
that's
yeah,
why to go around, just
yeah,
don't touch
yeah
the flaps till you're hit yourself 100, 200 feet.
It's
okay.
Good to see that.
So we came in at 90. As opposed to 80, you saw what happened. Yep. Good practice though. So go around as just these, wait, and right about here I'd start messing with the flaps one at a time. But you saw that balloon?
Yeah, no,
on
I did.
On the backside of balloon would have been
yeah
come down hard. So if you ever do that again by yourself, just go.
Port Jeff, November 26794, crosswind 12.
It happens.
Mountain BP 31.
BP 31, good.
Jacket with traffic 06 south, 9 miles to the east on the ILS approach, Jacket.
Warden traffic, Cessna 6304 Kilo is 6 miles to the north inbound for a full stop on 14, Warden.
Where is it going?
Warden.
Okay.
Yeah, Warden sounds like LaPorte on the radio a lot.
Green Canyon 19, Green Canyon 19, Shell 16.
Number 5 and 6.
Point traffic November 26794 is downwind for 12 at left base.
Sir, I just use the restroom and get right back out.
Roger.
Port traffic, November 26794 is final 12. Full stop?
Yep, full stop. Watch your speed all the way in. Aim point near speed all the way in. Aim point near speed, right at 80. That one's on the runway, so you're clear. Turn right, right. Nice job. Alright, reset carb heat, reset flaps. Alright, go do as much as you want. Maybe 5 or 6, whatever you feel comfortable with. If you need a break, just come take a break. If you don't like them, go around. No big deal. If the winds get too much, transition to 2-3. But I don't think they're too bad right now. You feel comfortable going by yourself?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think you're fine. What else? Just remember the fundamentals, you'll be fine for the basics. The only thing I say is at airspeed, just watch at airspeed. That's the only thing that'll kill you. Excuse me. Again, if you're not adding power by the crossing runway, full stop it. But I'm fine with you doing touch and goes.
Okay.
Any questions?
Nope.
Alright, so let's see, trim set, flaps are up, carb heat's in, I think you're ready for takeoff. If you see me waving like this, just make it a full stop.
Okay.
But don't be looking at me on landing. I'll be out here if I have to bring in for whatever reason. Have fun.
I will. 24 traffic, November 26794 is taking the active 12 for patterns. It's alive.
Wiser traffic, pipeline 364 Charlie Papa is about 4 to the southeast of the airport. Going to be transitioning about a mile to the east and depart to the northeast. That was for LaPorte.
Port traffic, November 26794 is crosswind 12. Port traffic, November 26794 is down 112. Port traffic, November 26794 is left base 12. Eighty knots. Fast correcting. There's eight. Port traffic, November 26794, final 12. Turn now. A little ones. Port traffic, November 26794, up 112.
Noble 1-1, go ahead. That's a green deck for landing on Bullwinkle for Noble 1-1, thanks.
Port traffic, November 26794, down 112.
Bill traffic on 9120 November, 8 to the south will be entering the 45 for the left downwind, runway 12.
John traffic, Cessna 739 Mike Ely has 5 miles west, descending out of 1400 inbound for 17. Thank you.
Port traffic, November 26794, left base 12. Three more seconds. Port traffic, November 26794, final 12. Flaps are down, 80 knot approach.
Port traffic, Cessna 6218 Hotel is about 4 miles northeast, transitioning the area northeast southwest bound. We're 1800. Port traffic.
floated one or two of those, but...
What's that?
I floated one or two of those, but...
They looked alright, though. They looked good.
Yeah.
You had enough?
Yeah, I noticed that I would... I'm still kind of high, and I was definitely bleeding it out a lot more towards the...
Okay.
Like short final, but there's a little self-critiquing, I guess.
It looked like they were coming a little fast, and then you bleeded. Just from my perspective, it looked like they were coming a little
fast.
Yeah, you tend to gain speed when you turn base to final. You tend to gain speed there.
I don't know. I think it's just because of the nose down and in the turn. And I'm not pulling the power
just
back.
Just pull. Yeah. It's just constantly adjusting power.
Oh, that's right, good cool. With the canopy open. Where to next, sir?
We can head on back if you want, unless you need to do more.
Kind of spent.
Yeah. Stop right here, make a call, make sure no one's coming.
Port traffic, November 26794 will be taking active 1-2, departing to the south. Clear final. Nobody else. I guess that was the other thing too, is that clear final here, but I need to also be looking out.
Yeah, 2-3, yeah. I mean, they look good though. You're not bouncing or nothing, so.
I know, my first solo, I PIO'd it.
I know, I remember that one.
Not these cranes, the next cranes, right? Or no, that's different. Yeah, that's
these cranes. Yeah, it's those over there, yep.
So what's this highway? Not this one, but the one that intersects.
What's that?
Which highway is this over
146.
Here? 146. Okay, so we just go down 146.
Yeah, just go to 146 and then pick up ATIS call tower. Once you make calls tower, turn on in.
Okay. Hertz.
You already got it set.
Okay. 1216 is ground. I'm still trying to memorize all this.
Make a little note card if you need to or something. Bring with you. Throw it on your knee board or something.
Not this one, the next one, right?
Yep.
This one?
Bottom one.
18017, visibility 10. Sky clear, temperature 25, dew point 18, altimeter 29991. Landing runway 17 right, expect ILS approach. Advise on initial contact, give information, Victor.
Victor?
Hey, where are you at? Going westbound, we're 1600 feet, about 3 miles east of Morgan's Point, 06 uniform.
Is that us?
704 Alpha Charlie.
So D2. How do you clear this? Clear?
But I can hit direct to.
Direct to.
KEFD. Or I'll tell you, go to the big knob to that little nearest. Go to the big knob till you see the nearest little knob. Nope.
Yep.
Go back to the big. Alright. Push the cursor. Don't worry about it. Fly the plane first. Let's get out of that for a minute. Just level off here. Pull your power back a little bit. You don't need that. It's right over there. You're 7 miles to the east. Once we get configured, we'll do that.
Okay.
And switch freaks, you can call tower.
Tune in
gauge
1100.
How do you back out?
Oh,
I'm 7, looking magnetic.
Okay.
Now, big knob to this is nearest.
Where do you see it nearest?
Clear. Always a big knob to get to where you want. Alright, big knob, now little.
Okay.
Alright, see where it says nearest?
Yeah, okay.
Highlight that tab with the big knob. Now, little knob. Enter, nope. Enter. One more time. There you go.
Ditto. Mount to tower, November 26794, 7 miles east with Victor.
RG 26794, Arlington Tower, spot 5323.
5323 for November 26794. 53.
Alright, now you can go in. Once you make two-way comms, now you can make a turn.
Follow this road all the way back, right?
Yeah, but you can go on over there now. You don't have to go this way all the way over there. Save you a few minutes. But you're right, that road to that road, yeah. The other way is you hit direct to.
Proceeding bomb for left midfield downwind runway 17 right.
Left midfield downwind 17 right.
Left midfield for 17 right, November 26794.
So she wants you to enter the downwind. Alright, so how'd you do that?
What's that?
How would you do that?
Just enter in over here.
Alright, go ahead. I'd pretty much go to the big Boeing building or whatever that thing is.
Yeah, and then, okay.
Yeah, just aim straight for that. You know, ground track to that, I should say.
The winds are...
The winds will push you a little bit that way, so... And unless she says otherwise, expect a 600 foot pattern. You can request a 1000 foot pattern if you want. In fact, when you're solo, I'd want you to do a 1000 foot pattern, so I don't like 600 foot for students. Not good practice. Pull your power back a little bit, and let's aim again to the ground track. See how the wind's blowing us this way?
Yeah.
So put your nose left of that Boeing building, maybe 15 degrees or so, and then our ground track will maintain straight towards it.
Down to 600?
Yeah, I'll go down to 600.
Charlie, Arlington Tower, squawk 0457.
0457,
squawk
Charlie.
November 7th, on 4, you can start your turn towards the base and bypass midfield downwind. The Cessna, turning left base, runway 17 left.
And we'll call left base for 17 right, 26794.
And Tower 34 Kilo Fox 17 right at Bravo, ready for departure.
There you go, so those apartments right in front of you, those water towers, yeah. That little water tower, that's your base turn, it's your base corner right there.
Remember those apartments?
And our Centurion 34 Kilo Foxtrot, 27 right at Bravo, ready for departure.
34 Kilo Foxtrot, runway 17 right at Bravo. Winds 2208,
clear to takeoff. Clear to takeoff, you need sound departure, 44 Kilo Fox.
And tower 20, left on base to final.
Yes, sir.
And there's Julie Alpha, runway 17 left, check wheels downwind 2208, clear for the option.
Clear for the option, I 17 left, please hear you though.
For Alpha Charlie, make left traffic, runway 17 left, report midfield downwind.
Roger, I will expect left traffic for 17 left for Alpha Charlie.
Roman 7904, traffic off to your right, a mile and a half is a pop line, Skyhawk, southbound at 600.
PM,
looking for traffic.
And we're looking for the traffic now, 794.
Okay, go ahead, turn base, call base.
Tower, Coast Guard Copter 6603.
Coast Guard 6603, Arlington Tower.
6603 has Victor requesting a Leak City arrival, full stop.
Coast Guard 6603, squawk 5321, report 1 mile south.
6603, 5321,
Wilco. And call base.
Arlington Tower, November 26794, left base 17 right, full stop.
November
29,
hold pipeline traffic, no factory, runway
17
right,
check
wheels down, 21008, clear to land.
Clear to land,
4 Kilo Foxtrot, say direction to departure.
4 Kilo Foxtrot, head eastbound for now.
4 Kilo Foxtrot, roger, remain air below 600 for now. Traffic entering the downwind about 3 miles south of the Cessna at 900.
Okay, 600 for now for 4 Kilo Foxtrot.
4 Kilo Foxtrot is heading to your left slightly, 1 mile.
4 Kilo Foxtrot, have that traffic.
4 Kilo Foxtrot, maintain visualing pass behind him, please.
4 Kilo Foxtrot, roger, will do.
For off Charlie, traffic off to your left at 800 eastbound has you in sight.
I got traffic in sight, we'll maintain visual for off Charlie.
And number 4 Alpha Charlie, number 2 traffic to follow, turning left crosswind to downwind is a Cessna at 700, report traffic in sight.
Roger, we got a Cessna set, we'll maintain visual and we'll be number 2 behind him for 17 left, Cessna for off Charlie.
Top
line 7, traffic.
Yeah, so right here you're at 100, that's okay.
Cessna entering the downwind, 17 left at 700.
Bob 17 has that traffic, we want time visual separation.
Top line 7, roger, additional traffic, it's your 12 o'clock moving from your right to left eastbound at 700.
Bob 17 has that traffic as well, we'll want time visual separation.
Top line 7, roger. 4 Kilo Foxtrot, traffic off to your left at Pipeline Patrol Skyhawk.
Close exit of Bravo.
Southbound 600 has you in sight.
Okay, 4 Kilo Foxtrot, I'd like to continue my climb.
4 Kilo Foxtrot, at
Bravo?
Yeah.
4 Kilo Foxtrot.
Tower 450 Tango Romeo, visual 17, right?
Okay, Tim, 450 Tango Romeo, Ellington Tower, report turning left base runway 17, right. Peg and stay at pattern altitude of 1,600.
1,600, report left base, 17 right, Tango Romeo.
Oh, the Wildcat.
And a tower to place your jet up on base, 17 left.
0 Juliet Alpha, runway 17 left, trickles downwind 2007, clear touch and go.
Clear touch and go, 17 left, place your jet up.
Go ahead and switch, what's you up there? Just go ahead and switch it.
70, Lake Charles, 2,000 feet on initial altitude, 7,010 minutes after.
That's it, right? Stand by.
That's it. You have to start here, work your way up.
November 100, Victor Sierra, read back correct.
Alright, go ahead, give a call. At Bravo.
I like the ground, November 26794, at Bravo, request taxi back, Flying Tigers.
November 794, Arlington ground, hold short of hotel.
Holding short hotel.
Right, you can roll up a little bit though, just a little ways, not too much.